Hey, me and this watermelon are about to have us a picnic. Check that puppy out, man. Nice and melonized. La-da-da. Beautiful red melon. Love it. I love watermelon, man. It's just the greatest summer fruit that there is. That and the green melon. I don't know what you call it. Sweet melon or something. I do not like cantaloupe. I cantaloupe tonight because I hate the stuff. Yeah, hanging out outside. It's a beautiful night. Light fluffy clouds. You know, beautiful, beautiful. We got some bloomage down here. I gotta show you. Never did move those fucking rocks. Yeah, check this out. We got one of the bird-planted sunflowers. The birds plant these. They're outside the garden, and they drop them out of the feeder up here, and the seeds fall, and the little sunflowers grow. There's another one. They're kind of short. They're only about as tall as me. See, I'll show you. There's me and the sunflower. We're about the same height. So, anyway, hey, thought you might like that. So I'll throw that in my pop-up video for today. I hope you're having a good day. And my thoughts are with the families and friends of those who were murdered in Colorado last night. It's a tragedy, and it's horrific and never should have happened. Peace. Because I stopped you from seeing the funnest part is how drippy this is. I mean, this is some really wet watermelon. I have to stand outside on the porch to eat it because it's just dripping everywhere. All right, check it out. Ooh. Puddle. Dripping watermelons. And it's awesome. Look how red that is, man. And, oh, it's the absolute perfect texture. So, anyway, yeah, enjoying my evening with Nola. I even gave Nola a piece, but she's not gonna eat it. Not gonna eat your watermelon, are you, Bubba? No watermelon for the dog? Dogs don't like watermelon, but they like beaches? They like to go to the beach, huh? That's what dogs like. She's so fucking cute. Kind of a little bit of a mess. I haven't showered yet, but I did recover from my migraine. I'm headed to get in the shower now and clean myself up and possibly go to the Stratum Fair tonight, unless Pat's going to come down to go with me tomorrow night. I'm still waiting for an answer from her on that, so I'm not sure. But I'm going to shower and dress anyway, in preparation, because I think not hearing from her may be a signal that she's not going to come down tomorrow night. But, yeah, it's been a really bizarre and tragic day, obviously, as most everybody knows, you know, with the Colorado shooting that I posted about first thing this morning, yeah, and stalkers and just very strange, violent crap, you know, is it a full moon? Are people really losing their minds like this? We're becoming just this really savage sort of society in some ways, and it's really scary. I know that going to the movies now is not going to be as relaxing as it used to be. You know, don't you think? Don't you think that every time you sit down in a movie theater, you're going to think about that? You know, over 50 people being shot in one movie theater in under 3 minutes? You know, and they thought it was part of the movie, so they just sat there and waited, and, you know, which just gave him more time. Yeah, really, really bizarre. They said that they have upped all the security at every theater showing A Dark Knight across the country in case this is some sort of a, you know, in case there are other copycat attacks or other planned attacks like it, in case the guy is part of some group or something, but... Yeah, it's going to make going to the movies similar to swimming in the ocean after the movie Jaws. I saw Jaws when I was in the seventh grade, okay? It came out
I never swam in the ocean after that, except for one time in Providence, Rhode Island, on a trip with my ex and some friends. I did swim that day, and it was a hurricane, so it was riptide, and we were damn near killed, but we won't, it was so fun, we all had to try it, body surfing in those huge waves. So, yeah, I did that. That's the one time in all the years since 7th grade. Now I go in and get my toes wet, but I do not go above my ankles in the ocean because them sharks will drag your ass out in 2 feet of water. So Jaws entered the ocean for me. I cannot go to the ocean without even thinking about Jaws. Now this guy, this James Holmes guy, has entered movie theaters. I didn't care for the movie theater to begin with because it's uncomfortable. The seats suck. They don't have like intermission anymore where you can get up and go get snacks anymore or any of this stuff. They don't pause the movie. So I just don't like it anyway. And now I like it even less and even less likely to go because of the fact that I will sit down and I will think about this guy and I will think about that incident and I will not be relaxed, And the psycho stalkers are making it really feel insecure to be doing videos and shit and to be participating in social stuff. This is sad. It's really sad that because of shit like this, we stop ourselves from doing things in life. And of course, that's their idea. Fuck us up mentally so that we'll stop having a good time. So that, ruin it for everybody. It's a fucked up way to think. I really hate it. I feel so bad for the families and the friends and the moms and dads and kids and brothers and sisters and cousins and grandparents that lost people yesterday or last night. That guy surrendered right there in the middle of the theater with no resistance. Okay? Take him directly to the electric chair and fry his ass. No, you're gonna spend millions of dollars doing an investigation on this guy. Okay? Studying him, testing him, make sure he was sane. Maybe he was insane and we can just let him go free. Fuck that. Straight to the electric chair, I say. Don't pass go. Why waste another red cent on his stupid ass? Okay? Fry him. Justice for justice. Eye for an eye. Fuck this. I mean, this is what we. My personal opinion, we gotta start slamming down on shit like this, okay? Rapists, murderers, anybody who touches a child inappropriately or harms an animal inappropriately, I'm done, man. Personally, I got no sympathy for your ass. I hope they put you in fucking jail and they kill your ass in there immediately. I don't hope they don't even wait 3 fucking days. I hope some son of a bitch bends your ass over in the shower while another one cuts your throat. Ugh, angry man. The justice system in this country, there is no fucking justice unless you're a criminal. And then you get nice, cushy 3 hots in a cot, and recreation, and TV, and video games, and conjugal visits, and, hey, the guards will even fuck you for a quarter. It's just not right. Fry 'em. Anyway, from watermelon to frying a dude in the electric chair we go. Hope you're having a good day. Remember to keep those people in your thoughts and prayers, and everybody else that's having a hard time in this world. I can't complain about my life. There are people that have it 10 times, 20 times, 30 times worse. There are people that, struggle so hard every day to make ends meet, and then other people that just take lives like this. Said, I hope we can get a handle on this and get it under control. I think it's time for the United States citizens to take this shit into their own hands. Our government and our judicial system is not working for us. It's working against us. So, it's time. I say revolt. Talk to you later. Peace and love to all.